What's going on, YouTube? Today, Brawl Stars has released its newest challenge. It is the highly requested showdown challenge that the community has been asking for. This may be the singles challenge, however, every single map is going to be duo showdown. To win a game, you are going to have to get first or second place, third or fifth is not going to cut it, and you have to go 11 wins with at most 3 losses. If you hit 4, it's no big deal though. A re-enter is only 1 gym because of this special event, which is awesome. Literally anybody can win this challenge. Whether you have a buddy or not, in this video, we are gonna be covering every single brawler you're gonna need to win those games on each map. And we are gonna do it in just 5 minutes. So let's go ahead and hop right on into it. All right, our first map is Rockwall Brawl. Now for this map, the number one brawler I'm going to recommend is Colonel Ruffs. Remember, this is a passive game mode, meaning you only need to get second place or better to get the job done and advance to the next game. Ruffs is a great brawler for this. He's a great duo in general because of his star power, which allows you to give HP to your teammates over time. I believe it's about 30 a second. Ruffs also counters a lot of aggressive brawlers in the meta right now that especially show up in duo showdown in this map, like Surge, Stu, and also the Sandbags do a great job into single shot brawlers, and brawlers like Gene who show up a lot. Gene's the other brawler I'm going to recommend for this combo. Remember, it's a passive game mode. Gene does a great job at just being an overall balanced brawler that can deal with just about anybody, not a lot of hard counters or anything like that, and has the passive ability to heal your teammates. If you're feeling more aggressive, you could go something like Stu and Surge. Surge is going to be a great option in this map in general. Can use the teleport to go through the walls and really deal with squishier brawlers. Other alternatives as well. Edgar, great alternative for duo showdown in general. He's going to be somebody that shows up later down the road as well. And Sprout, the only thing you have to worry about is the aggressive brawlers. But Sprout can do a great job with the walls of hitting shots. Up to you. On to our next map. All right, hopping into map number 2, we have Skull Creek. Now, for this map, I think it plays out pretty similarly to our first. A lot of the fighting occurs in the middle area, so honestly, I think a great combo here is going to be Ruffs and Edgar. Edgar is going to do really well on this map because there's going to be so many throwers. You're going to see anything from Sprout to Dynamike, and Edgar just does a great job if you can cycle that super. Even use that gadget if you want to pop the free super, make sure you're getting those kills. And then Ruffs can power up the Edgar, give him a bunch of HP, make him really beefy. And I think that is a duo to be reckoned with on this map. If you want to go thrower, you can do that too. Again, there are some great options. If you're a Dynamike fan, this isn't a bad one to pull out the Dynamike stun on. To use that against the aggressive brawlers. Sprout, also a safer thrower option here, owning the middle area in general. And again, Gene is a great alternative here too. But overall, I think Edgar is going to be great here for all the squishy brawlers. And Ruffs is just a good duo mate to power him up. Okay, hopping into our third map, which is Safety Center. For this map, I'm going to recommend running Gene in a long-range brawler. Gene, like I mentioned earlier, is just a super awesome duo option. And for the long-range brawler, I'm going to recommend going Meg here. Meg is unique in the fact that she can play really well at the long range and the short range. I think this map has a nice blend of both with all those walls, but also those lanes for long-range fights. I think Meg is going to be great in the Meg form, and with a bunch of cubes, that swing is going to do so much damage if you can close the gap and hit the enemy brawlers. If you don't have Meg, I know she's a legendary brawler and newer. Belle also works here. Belle is a great long-range brawler in general, but ultimately, you can go with your comfort picks. Gene and Ruffs, of course, are going to work here too. And now on to our final map. All right, we are on our final map, which is Dark Passage. This is a very long range map. You're only going to need 2 wins here, unlike the other maps where you'll need 3. I would pair Gene with a long range brawler like Piper. Piper's ambush star power is going to be really strong in the top right area of this map, along with Gene. Gene does pretty well in the long range brawlers as well. Can't really be 1 or 2 tap most of the time by a Piper. And brawlers like Gene, Belle, opposing Megs aren't going to be able to one-shot Gene by any means. I think this is going to be a strong duo if you can make it. Keep in mind that there are 2 spawns at the bottom of the map, 3 spawns at the top. Just keep that in mind off-spawn when you're going for boxes. Be aware of your surroundings. You definitely want to get that top 2 placement so you can get a win. So you don't want to be getting overly aggressive at the beginning and keeping in mind what's going on around you. If you don't like Piper, Piper's not your strong suit, Belle, Meg, or the classic Gene Ruffs, like I've been saying, will also work here too. With that being said, that wraps up all 4 maps for this 11-0 challenge. All right, that wraps it up for this video, guys. Appreciate y'all sticking around. I woke up bright and early this morning to get this cranked out, so I would appreciate if you drop a like and subscribe. I do everything on the channel myself, so anything you all can do goes a long way. Hope I provided enough brawlers for you to have enough different combinations to try out. Duos is a crazy mode, a little different than 3v3s, but I know you all are going to get this done and get some nice wins. And with that being said, that wraps up the video. See you all in the next one.